إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة دلالة وكل دلالة في النار. Verily, all the praise and all of the glorification and all of the magnification, ya ikhwani, ya akhwati, no doubt, it is due to Allah and Allah alone. And I publicly, inwardly, and outwardly attest to the fact that there is nothing or no one worthy of worship as a deity except for Allah Jalla Shanu. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the finality of messenger sent to guide mankind from the darkness into the light. Ya ikhwati fillah, ya akhawati fillah, al-unwan al-yawm, al-ghuluwa fi al-deen, fi hayat al-muslimin fi mu'assira. Our topic for today, inshallah ta'ala, is the topic of extremism in the modern times of the modern Muslims. And we find, ya ikhwan, Monday or Tuesday, as we see, that unfortunately something happened very terrible in Mumbai, which used to be Bombay. And when you turn on the TV, they're blaming people who are trying to associate themselves with the religion of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are here to tell the brothers and the sisters that extremism is not from the religion of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we find, ya ikhwan, that when the ulama al-Rabbaniyun, when they look at any word in the Arabic language, there are five aqsam that we must look at first. The first one is al-lughawi, the linguistic meaning of a word. The second one is istilahi, the terminology of a word. The third one is the shari, the religious, legislated, sharia meaning of a word. And al-urf, the custom of the people in a particular land. And the last one is ijaz, which is like ta'bir, which is an expression. So when we look at ikhwan, what the ulama al-Rabbaniyun rahimahullah wa rahmatullahi wasiya, they had explained this topic in detail in one of the risales, one of the treaties that one of the ulama, he wrote in Medina Munawwara as one of his treaties for him graduating to get his PhD on this topic of al-ghuluwa fi al-deen fi hayat al-muslimin fi mu'assira. He went on to say that ghulu, the meaning of it is, the istilah meaning is, that a person, that he went to the extreme. So we find, ya ikhwan, that this is not from the religion. The Shaykh, he also brought a couple more words, inshallah ta'ala, which is common amongst the Arabs when you hear it sometimes on the radio in the Arabic language, or you read it in the newspapers, the word tatarruf, which is radicalism. This, again, is not from the religion of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to be a radical. And unfortunately, when you turn on the TV, we find that these names are being used against the Muslims. And like we said before, this has nothing to do with Islam, and anybody who's practicing this, they are not really from Islam. Also, tashaddud, meaning to be harsh and to be rigid and to be very severe. Again, tashaddud is not from the religion of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And al-unf, to be stern, to be stern. This is not from the religion of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the last one, at-tanatta, to be exorbitant or to be extravagant in your speech or in your action. So anybody who claims that they're on the religion of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and they're attached to these things, هذا ليس من الإسلام. This is not from the religion of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we have ya ikhwan ya akhwat, too many adalil as-sahiha min kitab wa sunnah al-sunnah mutahhara of Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam that is authentic, that show ya ikhwan that this is not from the religion. If I was to stand here this week, next week, and the week after that, we would just be skimming the surface of the book that the Shaykh wrote, Rahim, Hafizahullah Ta'ala. The Shaykh begins by quoting a hadith in Imam Bukhari where the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went on to say, إِنَّ الدِّينَ يُسْرٌ وَلَنْ يُشَدَّ الدِّينَ أَهَدٌ إِلَّا غَلَبُوا فَسَدِّدُوا وَقَرِّبُوا وَقَمَ قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. And we find that, Ikhwan, when you look and you read the hadith al-sahiha, it is as if you're hearing the words from the Messenger of Allah, it should be penetrating into your heart. The Messenger went on to say, verily this religion is easy. No one overburdens himself in religion except that it will overcome or overtake him. And he will not be able to continue in that matter. So seek this straight path, the path that should be followed. And we find that Ikhwan of the ulama Rabbaniyun, they want to say, and this is a principle that the people of Sunnah, Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they need to know about the Mumay'ah, those people who water the religion down. They try to make Islam something that it isn't, and on the other side is the ghulat, those who are extreme in their religion. We as Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we are supposed to be mundabit, mutawasit, in the middle. We find that Ikhwan, that the Messenger of Allah went on to say in the hadith, which is collected in Imam Bukhari in the Sahih, where the Messenger of Allah went on to say, أَحَبُّ الدِّينِ إِلَى اللَّهِ الْحَنَفِيَةُ الصَّمْحَةُ وَكَمَ قَالَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. And this is something, Ya Ikhwan, where we as non-Arabs, we don't understand the Arabic language the way that it should. And it echoes out, Ya Ikhwan, الْحَنَفِيَةُ الصَّمْحَةُ. What is الْحَنَفِيَةُ الصَّمْحَةُ? The ulama, they went on to say that الْحَنَفِيَةُ الصَّمْحَةُ is the true monotheistic religion that has a devotion to Allah, and it is the easy way, and this is the most beloved way. So we find that, Ikhwan, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would not be upon the path of people who are doing these criminal acts. And as a Muslim, living these days, when things like this happen, unfortunately some innocent Muslims, we are targeted for people trying to rebel and to treat us evil because of the ignorance of some people who think that they understand the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We find in Ikhwan that the Messenger was sent as a rahmah for the world. He was sent to guide mankind to what is better. We find in Ikhwan that the Messenger of Allah had to say in the hadith which is collected in Imam Muslim, he wanted to say in this hadith, Ya Ikhwan, we recently came across it, where the Messenger of Allah wanted to say, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَمْ يَبْعَثْنِي مُؤَنِّتًا وَلَا مُتَأَنِّتًا وَلَكِنْ بَعَثْنِي مُعَلِّمًا مُيَسِّرًا أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ وَأَخْرَجُهُ صَحِيحُ مُسْلِمٌ. The Messenger of Allah, Ya Ikhwan, he went on to say, Allah did not send me to be someone who is causing hardship to the people, making things hard for the people, but rather he sent me to be a teacher and one who brings the people ease. And did he not tell Mu'ad radiallahu ta'ala anhu when he sent him to Yemen, بَشِّرُوا وَلَا تُنَفِّرُوا وَأَسِّرُوا وَلَا تُيَسِّرُوا, make things easy for the people. Do not push them away and do not make things hard upon the people. And we find that, Ikhwan, those people who think that they understand the Quran and the Sunnah, that they go around doing these infamous acts, Ya Ikhwan. And again, what happens after that? Some people with the anger, they go and they target an innocent Muslim woman. They take off scarves of our Muslim sisters. And after 9/11, we find that so many Muslim sisters were harmed because of the acts of some foolish people who claim that they practice Islam. Where is the hikmah, Ya Ikhwan? Where is the wisdom, Ya Ikhwan? Where is the foresight, the farasa? Where is it, Ya Ikhwan, these days and times when we as Muslims are trying to be upon kitab and sunnah and we find that there's some ignorant people around us who think maybe because they have a beard and they have a kufi that their Islam is better than all the rest of us, that they go and they do stupidity that causes much harm to the Muslims. We find in Ikhwan that this religion is a religion of ease. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he went on to say in Surah Al-Hajj, making it crystal clear for every man and every woman that we know that our religion is a religion of ease and a religion of gentleness. We find that Allah ta'ala has told the believers, the Muslim men and the Muslim women, قال الله تعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما جعل عليكم في الدين من حرج. Allah Ta'ala went on to say, He has imposed no difficulties on you in religion. So anybody who claims that they're practicing Islam as understood by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions, know that this is a religion of ease. Allah does not want us to overbear ourselves or to become overbearing upon the people by being harsh and being hard upon the people. We find sometimes, unfortunately, some of the Muslims, when they go out into the street, they have very bad behavior. And I've seen some of the Muslims curse and swear at people in the street. We do not find that the Prophet ﷺ was fahishan or mutafahishan. He wasn't a person who would listen to evil words, nor did he speak evil words. Ya ikhwan, this religion is a religion of ease. Listen to Allah Ta'ala, as he went on to say in another verse, in Surah Al-Baqarah, in the 185th Surah, 185th verse, Allah Ta'ala wanted to say, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ يُسْرَ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمْ أُسْرَ. Allah Ta'ala wanted to say, Allah, He intends every facility for you. He does not want to put you into any difficulties. So ya ikhwan, a Muslim is one who wakes up in the morning, he worships his Lord, he treats his neighbor nice, he has a kind smile, he is easy upon the people. He doesn't go out and harm people in the street. A Muslim is one who when he sees something harmful in the street, he removes it. And as we know in the hadith, that this is the lowest form of iman. The lowest form of iman is to remove something harmful from the street of anybody, Muslim or non-Muslim. So how is it now that people who claim that they practice Islam go and cause that which is worse? That they will shatter glass, that they will harm, and they will hurt, and they will kill people. This is not from the religion of Islam. No matter how oppressed we are as a people, this is not from the way of the Anbiya. We find, ya ikhwan, many stories in the Quran where we find Musa alayhi salatu wasalam when he went to Faraon, lanatullah alayhi wa junudi. When he went to him, he never tried to come up behind Pharaoh and tried to assassinate Pharaoh or tried to harm Pharaoh. He came to Pharaoh with the most easiest words, perhaps, maybe, that his heart may be inclined to the truth. The Muslim is one that he has hikmah, that he uses good words, and he has good behavior with the people. But when we find that, ikhwan, when you go to the Don jail, or when you go to the East detention or the West detention, the majority of people that are in the jail at this particular time, ya ikhwan, based on my information, is the Muslims. Is the Muslims. And it's not only the youth. It's Muslim men, like we said, abusing their own Muslim women, like we said in the khutbah before. It is Muslim men stealing, robbing, cheating, not only the non-Muslims, but also the Muslims. I was told from a brother who is thiqa, who is a qualified individual, that another Muslim brother that I'm aware of took more than $80,000 in a business transaction with another Muslim, promised him that he was going to open a business, he took the money, and he fled the country. $80,000. Now when you look at this individual, he has a beard bigger than mine. He speaks Arabic much better than me. His skin is a little bit darker than me. And he knows way more Quran than me. But the behavior of the Muslims these days, that you'll steal money from your brother. Is this the religion that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came upon? Stealing, lying, and cheating to get a dollar? Ya ikhwan, there is something that we need to understand. Allah Ta'ala wanted to say in Surah Al-Ma'idah, مَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيَجْعَلَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ حَرَجِ. Allah Ta'ala wanted to say, Allah does not wish to place you in any difficulty. This religion, ya ikhwan, that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with, it is a very, very beautiful religion. This is one of the reasons, like people like myself, I accepted the religion of Islam. Because I fell in love with the Quran and the Sunnah and the companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When you go back and you read about the Anbiya, and when you read about the companions and the disciples of some of these great men, we find, ya ikhwan, that the behavior that they had, you sit and you read it, and you say, subhanAllah, do we have anybody left on the earth that has the behavior of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions? That they would actually go hungry so that their brother may have something to eat. That they'll go thirsty, that their brother will have something to drink. That they will take some of the money that was meant for their family and share it with their brother in Islam. This is something, ya ikhwan, when we read these books, and when we look back into the past, and when we look at the nature of the Muslims these days, how we're not rushing to get the front row in the masjid, but we're rushing to get the next Lexus or Mercedes, however we can, whether it's halal or haram. So when we drive down the road, the people say, wow, Abdullah, he's a distinguished individual. He has some money, he's very impressive. He's very successful. Ya ikhwan, unless Abdullah ends up into the Jannah, he's not a successful individual. Unless Fatima ends up into the Jannah, she's not a successful individual. Whether you have a big house, or a big car, or you have a degree, this is not a guarantee, ya ikhwan, that we're going to enter into the paradise. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions are light years ahead of us on their way to the paradise. We as Muslims, where are we, ya ikhwan? The most feared people on the earth are people who claim that they're Muslim because of some bad apples that are in the bushel. Ya ikhwan, the question comes, me as an individual, what am I doing? So the non-Muslims, when they see me, they know, no, Abdullah, he's a good Muslim. He's not from those crazy people. He's not from those people that have some problem. He's not a madman. Abdullah, he's a good man. He's very trustworthy. He has a good attitude. He speaks good words. And we have no fear coming from Abdullah's head. There used to be a time, ya ikhwan, that when we read, that when Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions would say a word on their tongue that they were going to do something, you can take that to the bank. It's a guarantee. Now the Muslims these days and times, we have a sickness called the inshallah, I'll never, ever, ever, never, sometimes, never, ever do it. Inshallah, I'll give my sadaqah to the masjid. Inshallah, I'll see you after salah, brother, and I'll bring you back that money. Inshallah, I'm going to go and do something positive for the community. And the Muslim, he may be able to fool us, but can he fool Allah Azza wa Jalla, ya ikhwan? You say in your heart, inshallah, I'm going to do this. Using the word of the name of Allah in the sentence that you're going to do it, but in reality, Allah, He knows the deepness in your heart. He knows that you're just being a hypocrite. Ya ikhwan, I do not say these words to make us feel bad. I say these words that it's a wake-up call for us now, ya ikhwan. That we as Muslims, again, we have been brought into the newspapers, on the radio, again, on the TV. Again, the world is looking to Islam again. What kind of religion is this? And as we heard just last weekend, we heard, and Allah, He knows the best, that Michael Jackson finally took his shahada after all these years. So people are still accepting Islam. And people are going to accept Islam. But let us, ya ikhwan, not be the people that when these people do come into the masjid, the first one that's going to swear to them will be Abdullah from the masjid. The first one that's going to cheat them is going to be Muhammad from the masjid. The first one that is going to do something evil, like in Ramadan we mentioned some of the Muslims punching another Muslim in their face. Imagine if a new Muslim came to the masjid and they seen this behavior in the house of Allah. You would drive the people away with that. Ya ikhwan, we pray that Allah makes us good Muslims and not extreme. Akhuli kuli hada wa astaghfirullah wa kum salam asmini ajma'in fa astaghfiruhu innahu wa ghafur. بسم الله الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا إخواني, the other day I got a phone call from my mother. May Allah guide her to Islam. She said to me, I'm just watching your people on TV as they've done a very horrendous deed. I said, Mother, these people have nothing to do with me and I have nothing to do with them. I do not know them, and they do not know me, and this is not upon the religion or upon that I claim. My mother said, well, they claim that they're Muslim. I said, mother, there are some people that have done some dastardly deeds on the earth. They claim that they're a Christian or a Sikh or a Jew. Does that mean that we judge all the Christians, Sikh, and Jew by one person? Or two people? Or 10 people? Or 20 people? Or 100 people? We find that, ikhwan, that it has to start now at a young age, the tarbiyah, where we teach our children that extremism is not from the religion of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We have, ya ikhwan, some more hadith which should make it crystal clear for the person who has aqil, he has intelligence, that our religion is a religion of peace. Al-Islam wa istislamu lillahi bit-tawheed. That Islam is a religion of complete submission to the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We find, ya ikhwan, in the hadith which is collected in Imam Ahmed, Ibn Khuzaymah, Nasa'i, Ibn Majah, Hakim, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to say, and listen very attentively, ya ikhwan. Iyyakum wa ghuluwa fi ddeen, fa innama halaka min kana qablakum bil ghuluwa fi ddeen, or kama qala sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Beware of going beyond the bounds of your religion. The people before you were destroyed by going to extremes in their religion. It is not permissible, ya ikhwan, that if something bad happens to the Muslims, that we, out of being musta'ajil, being hasty, we go and we do something stupid. This is not from the religion of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Also, the Messenger of Allah went on to say, "Halaka al-mutanati'un." The destroyed are the munati'un. Imam An-Nawawi went on to say, there are those who go to their extremes in their speech and in their actions. This collected in Imam Muslim and Imam Abu Dawud, that they go to the extremes. And this reminds us of another hadith where the Messenger of Allah went on to say, "Halaka al-nas fa huwa ahlakuhum." Halaka al-nas fa huwa ahlakuhum. That if a person says that the people are destroyed, in another narration, if he says that the people are destroyed, he has destroyed them or he has destroyed himself. So, any time that a Muslim thinks that he's better in terms of that no one else should be allowed to live on this earth which belongs to Allah, he has destroyed them, and in another narration, he has destroyed himself. Because remember, there's an individual who's more knowledgeable than the most knowledgeable of the ulama on the earth. His name is Shaytan Lanatullah Alayhi. But he had something called arrogance. At one time, Shaytan Lanatullah Alayhi, he had traveled the whole galaxy making worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he reached the level of the angels. But his arrogance, and his ignorance, and his pride ate him. He's going to head to the Jahannam Lanatullah Alayhi. So we find that, ikhwan, we as Muslims, we have a responsibility to be good, upright people, to be example for this society. The Muslim should be the number one person in the math class, in the science class, in the English class. He should be the hardest worker. He should be the cleanest individual. He should be the person with the most upright character. Is this not what the Messenger of Allah, he went on to say in a authentic hadith, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. I was not sent except for to establish the good character. We find in Ikhwan that it is a reminder for us, Allah Ta'ala, as he wanted to say in Surah Al-Ma'idah, advising Ahlul Kitab. And this is a lesson for us, Allah Ta'ala wanted to say in the 77th verse, La tablu fi dinukum. Allah wanted to say to Ahlul Kitab, do not go to exceed the bounds in your religion. Do not go overboard. So we find in Ikhwan, that when people invent something new into the religion, and they try to bring something which is not something that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam founded the religion upon, what they call the usul of the religion, we know, ya ikhwan, that we see people going to the extremes. We see people going to the extremes. How could a Muslim do something so evil, where the people are just going to work, and they're trying to provide for their family, and they go there, and they take people hostage, and they harm people, and they hurt people, and at the same time, they say that they are the mujahideen of the ummah. La wallahi ya ikhwan. This is not from the religion of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He did not come to be harsh upon the people. He did not come to hurt the people. He did not come to be a fitna for the people, but rather he came as a rahmah. We say that we follow Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it marches in front of us and we march behind it. The sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam marches in front of us and we march behind it. When the orders of Allah and His Messenger come, the believer in Allah on the last day, he says two things. Sami'na wa ata'na. Sami'na wa ata'na. I hear, O Allah and His Messenger, and I obey. Have we not heard, Ya Ikhwan, when Allah Ta'ala went on to say, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu istajibu lillahi wa rasooli idha da'akum lima yuhyikum? Have we not heard this verse? Oh, you will believe. Answer the call of Allah when Allah and His Messenger call you. Many of us, Ya Ikhwan, since 9-1-1, since the 18 brothers got arrested, we have been so afraid of our identity of Muslims that we stopped to promote Islam in this land. And I don't know about you, but I believe Allah has a great hikmah why many of us are here, even though many of us came here to Canada seeking hayat of dunya. Allah has a greater hikmah. I believe He brought us here to do the da'wah. My children, they go to the school around the corner, and more than 50% of the population at the school is Muslim, even though it's a non-Muslim school. So, when I came to the school and I registered my kids, I was afraid that the kids wouldn't be able to practice their Islam. And the non-Muslim teacher said, no, we have an abundance of Muslim kids here. Most likely, most of the kids are pretty good, but we have a few bad kids. So, Ya Ikhwan, let us look at us. Most of the Muslims are good, but we have some bad Muslims amongst us. Let us not be from amongst those people that are bad, Ya Ikhwan. Let us not be from amongst those people. When the people walk by us and say, oh my gosh, there's Abdullah. Stay away from him. He is a vile, he is a bad individual with bad character, bad morals, and possibly he can harm you. Let us not be from amongst those people. I ask Allah Azza wa Jal for us not to be from amongst those that are extreme in the religion, in our words or in our action. I ask Allah to protect the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I ask Allah to eradicate evil people from the Ummah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that make us look bad. I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to protect our women and our children from anything that happens because of the bad Muslims. I ask Allah that, inshallah ta'ala, He gives us the wisdom and He gives us the unity amongst Muslims, that we stay and we work together to promote the pure Islam in this land. With that, hadha ma indi wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in wa subhanaka allahumma wa bihamdika wa ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta wa astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Oh Allah, make us